And it's a very special day in which the readings are perfect for today. If we see in the Gospel, the disciples were in that room with the doors were locked, were closed. And Jesus showed up, and he breathed on them the Holy Spirit. The doors of the church has been locked for a long time, and we were missing to be able to come. But now, the doors with limitations are open. We are able to start to celebrate together the mystery of God's love in the Eucharist and renew ourselves celebrating together. And one thing that is beautiful in the Gospel is after Jesus appeared to his disciples, he said, "Peace be with you." What a beautiful way to reach them, "Peace be with you," to greet them. But what Jesus does after that? He led the disciples to see the wounds. He showed them his wounds. But what happened with the wounds that Jesus showed them? The wounds were healed. The wounds were healed. And how wonderful is for that, to see that part. And that is why Jesus is looking to send to us the Holy Spirit that give us life. I don't know, I would like to know more or less, do you feel comfortable wearing the mask? That is nice to wear that thing and put in your face. Sometimes you need to wear gloves. That is comfortable living in that way? We are ready to go out and put the mask away and breathe free. We are looking for a space in which we can be free of all this limit. We need to protect ourselves. I'm sorry that I'm doing that and I'm giving a bad example, but I cannot preach with a mask. I will be dying here. And you will not like to have a funeral here. But you know, we are looking to be free, to remove the things that make us feel uncomfortable. But how about our souls? How free are we? How free are we to express and to know the gift that Jesus gave us, the Holy Spirit gave to us? How free is our heart to express love, kindness, and compassion? How free are we? Maybe spiritually, emotionally, we are so ill, and we have different kind of ways to protect ourselves for the wounds that we have, that are painful, but not healed. We cover them. But in the same way that we are ready to remove the mask, the gloves, and everything, and to be free, what we are doing to remove all that stuff that make us unable to enjoy the gift ourselves, with the gift that Jesus gave us through the Holy Spirit to share with everybody. We're afraid to say that, to see that part. And that is why Jesus is giving to the disciples the gift of the Holy Spirit. And that in the same way that he showed his disciples that his wounds from the cross, from the passion and death, were healed. Look at that, are healed. He likes for us to have the same experience for the wounds that we carry in our souls and hearts and minds. Being touched by the power of the fire of the love of the Holy Spirit to heal us. We like to be free and breathe free without mask. How strong it is our desire to be free, to breathe freely, love, and be healed of the wounds that make us our lives so difficult, and unable to find joy in our own selves with the gift that we have, that sometimes we don't know. And when sometimes we like to have that gift there, but what about your own gifts that Jesus put in your own heart? And that gift is enough for us and for you to find the meaning of living our lives. We usually don't pray too much about the gift of the Holy Spirit. But the Spirit is what gives us life. And we need to ask, as we say in the Psalm, renew our hearts, not the face of the earth, renew the face of my heart every day, Lord, to find something new to help me to live my day today. Because always is something new. But we have two different masks, gloves, and things to protect ourselves, our hearts, and minds. And we are scared to death to receive the healing power that is coming from the Holy Spirit to make us free, to open completely our hearts, to express the beauty of our own selves, and become a gift to another one. The disciples in the beginning of the church, they performed great things, beautiful miracles. They were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit, with the joy and fire of love. We can do the same thing if we accept the risk to let Jesus to come to us, to our own selves, that we're so locked inside, afraid to be touched by love, that He can transform us and give us freedom and give us joy and peace. Sometimes it's so difficult to get along with the families because we don't know which one is my own gift to share. And we don't know how I can help because we don't know well our own selves. It's a beautiful day in which the doors of the church are open. We need to ask the Lord to do the same thing with our own hearts and give us the freedom of the Holy Spirit, that as we speak different languages and we are so different, something in common will keep us together and help us to grow together. That is love. When is love, everything is possible. We understand very well love, and that is the call for us to ask the Holy Spirit to help us to move forward in this situation that we are living. Yes, there are many different difficult times for us, but we cannot lose hope. And we need, this is the time that the Lord is giving us to taste our faith in Him and our trust in Him, that through the power of the Holy Spirit, as the disciples perform great signs, we become the same disciples performing great signs of love, mercy, and compassion. The Spirit gives life, and we need to be filled with that life, that will be transformed by love and be instruments of love to the service of our Lord Jesus Christ.